As Russian warplanes continue striking Aleppo, the carnage in Syria has pushed Moscow's relationship with the West to new lows. And with Western powers again debating military action, Russia has upped its forces in Syria.
Вашингтон не желает воевать с Россией.
And its Cold War rhetoric.
Российско-американские отношения. Надо.
In his flagship current affairs show, Russia's top state news anchor issued this stark warning of global war.
Дошло, что хамство по отношению к России.
Brutish behavior towards Russia, declared Dmitry Kisilov, could have nuclear dimensions. It is an apocalyptic vision, quite literally. Not since the conflict in Ukraine, where Russia fueled an eastern rebellion after annexing Crimea, have tensions between Russia and the West, particularly the United States, been so strained. Critics accuse Moscow of dangerously undermining the international order. But many Russians, former Cold War warriors like this retired general, see it very differently.
Russia is fighting US dominance over the world. That's the reason. It's not all about Syria or Ukraine. In Ukraine, it was a definite coup supported by the United States. So we have different views on the what's going on in the world.
So these are just flashpoints in a much larger battle.
Of course,
to fight of U.S. dominance.
Of course,
it's a battle to secure Russian interests in Syria to protect its last toehold of influence in the Middle East, in Ukraine to prevent yet another former Soviet state turning to NATO and the EU. It is a strategy, analysts say, that sets Russia and the West on a collision course.
Since collapse of the Soviet Union, the West had opportunity and capacity to reshape the whole world according to ideas which the West believed were correct and right. What we see now, there are attempts to believe that this arrangement, the post-Cold War arrangement, can be restored or prolonged. Unfortunately, not.
And what will replace it may not be to everyone's liking. Matthew Chance, CNN Moscow.